Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Gems of Knowledge. So I am here with another video on the chapter Polynomials, and today we are going to learn about the remainder theorem into this chapter. Okay, so before starting the video, make sure to subscribe to my channel and also click on the bell button to get the notification as soon as I post my new videos. Okay, so before starting this remainder theorem, you can see a note is given over here. Okay, let us first see what is this note here. So in general, if P of x and g of x are two polynomials such that the degree of P of x is greater than or equal to the degree of g of x and g of x is not equals to 0, then we can find polynomials Q of x and R of x such that, and you can see here a formula is given over here. Okay, so what this note state is, if here there are two polynomials, one is denoted by P of x and the other one is denoted by the g of x. If there are two polynomials over here and such that the degree of this polynomial is greater than the degree of this polynomial, either it is greater than or equal to. Suppose this is having the degree as 2 and this is having the degree as 1, and we should know that g of x cannot be equal to 0. It cannot be equal to 0. Then we can find two different polynomials here coming into picture, that is q of x and r of x, such that P of x is equals to g of x into q of x plus r of x. So this is into the form of this. Okay, we all have studied this into our previous classes, that is dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So how can we find, after dividing something, we can find that whenever the divisor, whenever we multiply the divisor into the quotient, and later on if we add with the remainder remaining, we are getting with the dividend. Okay, so this is what the note states here, this formula, that is P of x is equals to g of x into q of x plus this is nothing but the remainder, that is r of x. Okay, so we shall move on to the remainder theorem now. So you can see the statement of the remainder theorem here. Let P of x be any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so here you can see one polynomial has been given which is having the degree which is greater than or equal to 1, and let A be any real number. Okay, A is any real number present here. Then if P is divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, and if this P of x is divided by one more polynomial which is linear polynomial, in the sense we can say that the degree of this polynomial is 1. You can see here x is having the power as 1, so this is called as the linear polynomial. So when we divide this P of x with the help of this x minus a, okay, linear polynomial, then the remainder will be remaining as P of A. So this is the statement. So according to the statement, we need to prove this theorem. So here you can see the proof of the theorem has been given. Okay, so we shall start with the proof here. So let P of x be any polynomial with degree greater than or equal to 1. So P of x is a polynomial which contains a degree greater than or equal to 1. Then they have told us, suppose that when P of x is divided by x minus a, as we have seen here that the P of x must be divided by this linear polynomial, that is x minus a. Then what happens here is the quotient is q of x and the remainder is r of x. So let me give you one example over here. As you can see, whenever you divide any number here, suppose I'm dividing 20 with 2. Okay, so here what you are getting is nothing but 2 tens are 20 you are getting, and here you are getting 0 0. So what is this? This is actually known as remainder, and this is nothing but the quotient. Okay, this is called as dividend and this is called as divisor. Okay, so whenever we multiply this divisor with this quotient, and we are adding this remainder, what we are getting is this dividend we are getting, as you can see into the formula given here. Okay, so according to this, they have written here that when we are dividing this p of x with the help of x minus a, we are getting the quotient and we are getting one remainder. We are getting one quotient and one remainder. So that will be into this formula, that is p of x is equals to, okay, this will be our p of x, and we are dividing it with this, that is divisor. Divisor here will be nothing but x minus a, okay, and what we are getting quotient is nothing but q of x, and this is the remainder, that is r of x. Okay, since, next you can see, since the degree of x minus a is 1 and the degree of r of x is less than the degree of x minus a, so you can see here x minus a is having the degree as 1, it is having degree 1. As I told you here, you can see here it is given as constant polynomial. Just an example I have given you here. Okay, this is a constant polynomial. So what will be the degree of constant polynomial? It is having the degree as 1. Whereas the remainder, you can see here, it is remained with 0. And I told you that already into my previous videos, okay, that the remainder 0 polynomial will not have any degree. It is not at all defined. Till now, the degree of 0 polynomial is not defined. So it is not having any type of degree. Remainder is not having any degree. So that is what mentioned over here. Since the degree of x minus a is 1, it is having the degree as 1. And the degree of r of x, since the remainder is 0, it is having the degree less than x minus a, means it is 0. Means you can see here, the degree of r of x is equals to 0. So it means we can say that r of x is a constant. So we can write, instead of r of x, we can write it as r. So for every value of x, r of x will become r. Okay, so instead of writing this r of x, we can write it as r. Okay, so let us substitute into this formula now. It will become p of x will be as it is, x minus a will be as it is, q of x will be as it is, and instead of this r of x, it will become r. Okay, now in the next case, if your x is only equal to a, then what happens? In place of x, we need to substitute the value of a. So it will become p of a is equals to, in place of x, we need to substitute a again, minus a, into q of, in place of x, again we have substituted with a, plus r. So a minus a is nothing but 0, into q of a, plus r. So when we multiply 0 into q of a, so when we are going to substitute this 0 into q of a, we are getting the value as 0. So 0 plus r will be r. Something which is added with 0 is that number itself. So we got r here, hence we are proved with this theorem. So you can see here, as the statement says here, that the remainder will always be p of a. So you can see this p of a is nothing but equals to r. So this p of a is equals to r. So I hope this remainder theorem is cleared over here. So we will quickly move on to one more type of theorem present into this chapter, very very important, that is called as factor theorem. Okay, so here you can see a factor theorem has been given. So the statement to this factor theorem is, if p of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than or equal to 1, if this p of x is a polynomial which contains a degree which is greater than or equal to 1, and a is a real number, and suppose a is a real number, then there are two conditions which need to be proved into this theorem. So the first condition is x minus a is the factor of p of x. Okay, we need to prove that the x minus a is the factor of this p of x if p of a is equals to 0. If p of a is 0, then we need to prove that x minus a is the factor of this p of x. The second thing we need to prove here is, P of A will be equal to 0 if x minus a is the factor of P of x. That is the first one what we are proving here. We need to prove the converse of this into the second part. Converse in the sense we need to prove the same thing into reverse manner. Here proving that x minus a is the factor of P of x if P of a is equals to 0. And in the second case, if this P of a is equals to 0, then we need to prove this condition, that is x minus a is the factor of P of x. Okay, so here we shall see the proof of this theorem. So we know that from the remainder theorem we got a formula over here, that is P of x is equals to x minus a into Q of x plus P of a. So instead of the remainder we have used here the P of a. Okay, so the first condition, let us prove the first condition over here. If this P of a is equals to 0, then what happens to this formula? It will become P of x is equals to x minus a into Q of x, and this P of a, as it is 0, as it is 0 here, the only thing which is remained here is this much, that is P of x is equals to x minus a into Q of x. Okay, so this shows that the x minus a is the factor of P of x. Okay, since this x minus a contains some value here, since it is having some factors value, so since it contains some value here, we can say that this is a factor of this P of x. Okay, so let us see the second one. Since x minus a is the factor of P of x, okay, since we have proved over here that x minus a is the factor of this P of x, so what happens to this formula again here? P of x is equals to x minus a into, instead of this Q of x, it is replaced by some another polynomial, which is G of x. Okay, so you can see here for same polynomial g of x. Then what happens? Let us substitute this as a. Let us substitute x value to be a here. Okay, so it becomes P of a is equals to, instead of x, we need to write again a minus a into g of a. So a minus a, as it is 0, automatically this whole term will become 0. Since we multiply any g of a with 0, it is going to be 0 itself. So this is the proof of this second condition also. Hence this factor theorem is proved. So I hope everything is clear to you. If you are having any doubts regarding this theorems, then you can comment me down below. So in the next video we are going to continue with the exercises 4.3, which is related to the remainder theorem, and as well as the exercise 4.4, which is related to this factor theorem. Okay, I'll soon be back with those exercises. So till then, stay tuned and stay connected. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. I always see that most of you are watching to my channel, but you have not at all subscribed to it. So do hit the like button also and get subscribed to my channel for more videos like this. Okay, thank you.